Now the water cycle. Before, we know read about the water cycle, how water come downside and how it moves up high in the sky. So that is water cycle. Now we are read about it. Before we learn about the water cycle, let us study the process of evaporation, condensation. Firstly, we become to know about evaporation process and condensation process. After that, we have to understood the concept of water cycle. Now, firstly, evaporation. On a rainy day, a few hours after the rain stop and sun come out, whenever rain stop and after that sun coming, so the puddles of water disappear. Now puddles, it's a small pool of liquids that disappear, that water body disappear. How? So this happened due to the heat of the sun. Now that small drop are disappeared with the help of heat of the sun. So whenever on heating, water changes into water vapor and moves up. Okay, whenever too much heat is coming, then that water change into water vapors, so and moves up. That process is called evaporation. Some example of evaporation in our daily life. Sweat from our body dries due to the evaporation. Which is sweat? Sweat is the example of our daily life. After some time, now your body dry up. How? With the help of evaporation. We clothes dry when we put them in the sun. Our clothes are dry up now. How? With the help of the process evaporation. Now evaporation is a faster when it is in windy or sunny and the exposed surface area is more. Now evaporation is faster in which conditions? Firstly, there is a too much wind is there, too much heat is there, and area is also a much more. Okay, if area is more, then evaporation is more. Salt is also do you know now about this? The amount of water vapor present in the air at a given time is called humidity. Bache, after water removed from the surface, okay, some water not move high in the sky, okay, that water vapor are present in the air, that is called humidity. So it is more in rainy season and makes us sweat. Okay, so in rainy season you have to see humidity. Salt is also extracted from sea water using the process of evaporation. Now extracted, it means remove. Salt is removed from the sea using this process, evaporation process. Now dikes are made on the shore to prevent sea water from flowing back into the sea. Now dikes are embankments. Embankments are made on the shore. Why they are making a dikes? To prevent the flow of water, okay, backside, to move backside, to stop that process, they are making a dikes. So these areas with dikes are called salt pans. Where is dikes are made na, that area is called salt pans. Salt pans means like a container. The water in these pans gradually evaporate, leaving a layer of salt behind. Now in these pans, which water have that remove from the these pans gradually, it means slowly removed from the pans, and that is evaporation. If water is removed from the surface, so that leaving a layer of salt behind. And when it removed water, when water removed from the pans, and that leave the layer of salt, and we get, and this is the salt we eat after it is refined in factories. Directly we not used, okay, to consume it, not directly we consumed, after refined it in the factories, then we got salt. Now the process of condensation. On cooling, water vapor change back to the drop of the water. How? This is called condensation. See here example. When we boil water in a kettle, okay, we boil water in the kettle and we can see steam coming out from its nozzle. See here the example. Bache, when we heat our kettle inside water have, that we heat. And this is the nozzle of the kettle. And you have to see on small, small vapors coming from the steam coming from the nozzle. So if we place a plate in front of nozzle, see here, you have to place a plate, okay, in the front of nozzle. Then after that, you have to see, we find that water, small, small water droplet, we find on the surface of plate. Okay, so this is condensation. This is the process is called condensation. So dew drops on leaves in winter is an example of condensation in our daily life. Bache, in the winter season, you have to see leaves of the trees and a small, small droplet on it. And that is the condensation process. That is the our daily life example you have to see. Water is circulated continuously in nature in the form of the water cycle. So water is continuously circulated. How? So during this circulation, it keeps changing its forms. How? See here. This is the see here picture of the water cycle. Firstly, here collected water. Okay, that collected water are evaporate. Okay, evaporate. And after that condense, okay, and when there is too much water is collected inside the clouds, after that it split, it breaking, and then precipitation come downside, okay, rain is come downside. So in the form of this is the process is called water cycle. So here we read about this. Water evaporate firstly from the rivers or lakes and other water bodies. From the other water bodies, water is also evaporates. So because of the heat of the sun, why it evaporate? With the help of heat of the sun, some of this water changes into water vapor and rise in the sky. So in the sky, evaporate water, so as it goes higher and it meet cold air, but a higher in the higher layer there is a cold air is present. So whenever that evaporation water, that evaporate water reaches very much higher, then it meet with the cold airs. So and that water is condensed in the form of small, small droplets. Here we read na, okay, from the cloud. After that, that form a clouds. Condensed water form a cloud, and as much more as more and more drops join to the clouds, more and more evaporation process is going on. So too much water is collect inside the cloud. After that, whenever it become too very heavy, then it break. Okay, cloud is a burst. It means breakdown. So this water from the clouds reaches the ground in the form of the rain. Now in the form of the when cloud is burst, then water is reaches on the ground in the form of rain, in the form of hail. Hail is the small balls of ice, snow, as it is ice and sleet, it's the liquid form of ice. So this is precipitations. Precipitation is rain, hail, any form of the rain, in the form of hail, in the form of snow, in the form of sleet. So that process is precipitations. Water reaches to the water body on the earth due to precipitation and again evaporate. Now bache, firstly we read about precipitations na. Water reach to the water bodies on the earth due to precipitations, due to rain, water coming and fill the water bodies, and after that again evaporate water, and this process is continuously going on. So that's why it is called a water cycle. So this water cycle goes on endlessly in nature. So continuously this process is going on. Okay, never ending. I hope, bachche, you understood the chapter very well. Thank you.